Hello viewers, welcome back to my channel Sharing is Fun. Today we are going to talk about planning for a second baby, that when we should plan for a second baby. So in this video I'll be sharing my views, what is my views for planning for a second baby, what are factors we should consider before planning for a second baby. So let's get started. So the first factors which comes in my mind whenever I think for a second baby, actually our plan is not to leave Samaira alone. Definitely our plan is to have a second baby, but when to have, that plan is not yet decided, like when we are going to have a second baby. To leave Samaira alone, we wish that definitely she would be having a sibling of hers, so that she can have someone to share all her thoughts and everything. The first thing which comes in mind whenever we think is what should be the age gap between the two childs. What I mean is, already my daughter is 1.5 years, so what should be the correct age to plan for a second baby? How much gap is ideal for it? Actually, in general, it's preferred that once you deliver a baby, just wait for at least 18 months before preparing for a second baby. If you ask about my plan, so we are planning that till Samaira turn 4, we won't plan for a baby. Like once she turn 3, we will start planning for a baby, so that once she turn 4, we could have a baby. We'll plan at the age, once she reached at the age of 3, because it won't happen like once you start planning immediately you will conceive. It will take time definitely to conceive a baby. It's just our views, because we should consider mother age as well as mother health as well before planning for it. In general, it's said that after mother reaches 35, it's very difficult to conceive a baby, and father reaches 40 years, it become quite for them to become a father. Our plan is that only that before I reach 35, we should plan for a second baby if we want it. So this is the first point which comes in our mind. Other than this, we have to consider many other factors as well. Like in 3 years, will my baby, my first baby, is mature enough to do all the things by herself? Some experienced mother do share their views that after baby turned 3 years, they started doing many of their work by themselves, like eating, going to potty and many other works, and also they start their schooling and all. So my plan is also same, like if Samaira is start her schooling by the age of 3 and she start doing her some work by her own, then we may plan for a second baby after she complete 3 years. After that, we do have many other things which we should keep in our mind before planning for a second baby. Actually, I learned many things from my first pregnancy, which we are not aware of when we are delivering our first baby. Like the time when we deliver a baby, we need someone there to support for baby, for mother, and not only for them, for the father as well. So if you would have already seen my previous videos, my pregnancy videos, you would already be aware that during my pregnancy, actually I was not having anyone there, unfortunately, to support me. Just my husband was there. Then this corona came, so no one else can come later as well. So since her birth till now, me and my husband is only looking after her and taking care of her. So even this comes in my mind that with Samaira, will I be capable enough to look after another kid? So as per my experience, I think this time whenever I'm planning for a second baby, I should call someone from my relative before itself, like before I start planning itself, I would discuss with them that I'm going to plan something, means for a baby, are you be capable enough to come to me and stay with me to care for my baby? So these are all things I'm planning to discuss before itself with my family, with my relative. As by God grace, my first delivery was a normal delivery. It doesn't mean that the second one also will be normal. So no one knows actually, no one can predict this before. So I am planning definitely I'll call some of my relative who can come and support me during that time, that both me as well as my baby will get a support during that time. And definitely for my husband too, because in my first pregnancy, my husband was the only person who was looking after me as well as my baby, so it was a quite difficult time for him. So if someone would be there to support him as well, that would be good enough, because he cannot share everything with everyone. For a man, it's quite difficult to share every things, especially related to this personal things with anyone. Everyone won't think, but actually it's a quite difficult time for them as well. If I tell about something else which comes in my mind is financially, are we that stable, or are we ready financially that we can afford a second baby? Like, if once a baby comes in your life, you cannot imagine how expenses will grow like anything, because you don't think, but actually it happens. See, because small things like diapers which we use every day, though the each diaper cost less, but if you calculate for a year, it comes a huge amount. So we have to decide accordingly that are we ready for a next baby. Even baby vaccinations will be quite expensive as comparison. Nowadays actually it went more expensive, and we do spend so much of monies on that. So before we plan for a second baby, this also comes in our mind that do we financially that stable that we can afford a second baby as well. We can give a good every facilities and all to the second baby along with the first one. We do things that can we give a proper education to the babies which we are planning. For my daughter, actually the time when she born, that time itself I planned for a Sukanya Samriddhi Yojana. Actually, if you are having a baby girl below 5 years, definitely you should go for Sukanya Samriddhi Yojana. It's having lots of benefit for a girl baby. I have opened the time when she born, that next day itself, not next day, means within a week when we got her birth certificate, we have made that we have opened the account for some Sukanya Samriddhi Yojana for her. It will actually help in her education as well as for marriage or whatever higher education you are planning for your baby. So definitely I would recommend that you should open an account, Sukanya Samriddhi Yojana account, for your girl baby who is below 5 years. Only for education, if you are planning your daughter marriage during that time, even it will be helpful a lot. Other than that, which comes in our mind when we are planning for a second baby is your baby, age gap is that much that your first baby things can be reused for the second baby, like her books and all, if their standards are not that much difference. If your baby is 2 years, 3 years old, books and all of your first baby can be reused for your second babies, as well as clothes, then toys and all that can be used. See, if the age will be too much, then definitely we are not going to keep all that things for so long. You will notice that if a sibling is having more than 3 to 4 year age gap, there are some understanding gap between the siblings, because there is age gap. Definitely due to age gap you will feel the understanding gap. That's a very common thing. If I share my sibling experience, like me and my sibling is having 2 year of age gap, which was quite good if you are having a joint family, not for a nuclear family, because a nuclear family you don't have anyone to look after you as well as your baby. So it's better to plan for a 3 year age gap between your siblings. Hope you like the videos. If you really like the video, do subscribe my channel, Sharing is Fun, and don't forget to hit the bell icon so that whenever I upload a new video you get the notifications of it. If you find my views helpful for you in any way, do share it with your near and dear one and provide your comment in the comment section what really you find as helpful. For the mom who is already a mother of two baby, I really request you do provide your comments, you do help me if I miss something, and do guide me wherever I can improve or what all things I should think before. Thanks for watching. Hope to see you in next video. Stay safe, stay healthy.